Well, Iloilo City is enforcing its own enhanced community quarantine. The city mayor, Jenny Treñas, has taken steps to ensure that his constituents have access to sufficient food, apart from other efforts to contain the COVID-19 outbreak. We'll be discussing all of these efforts with Iloilo City Mayor Jerry Treñas, who joins us from Iloilo City. Maayong gabi po, Mayor Jerry.
Maayong gabi, Tony.
And thank you very much for joining us on this special coverage. Mayor, just to update us, kamusta na po ang COVID-19 situation po sa inyong lungsod at saka sa buong Iloilo po in general?
For Iloilo City, we were told that there was one who was considered positive yesterday. Mm-hmm. So there are now four patients who are positive in Iloilo City with one disease. And we are watching the arrival of OFWs from Manila, and we are also preparing isolation centers for them.
Mm-hmm. I understand, Mayor, that what is it? The Iloilo Convention Center po ang kinoconsider po na parang isolation or quarantine facility?
For a while, we considered the Iloilo Convention Center. Mm-hmm. But it gave us some difficulties. We are now using the Jubilee Hall for 100 patients, and the FINMA, University of Iloilo, has mm-hmm. offered the use of their school also for an isolation center. And we will be able to put in about 100-150 patients there.
Mm-hmm. So ito pong, Mayor Jerry, ito pong ECQ sa Iloilo City, you've also extended it to the end of April. How are people getting access to food while they're under lockdown?
All the essential establishments like the groceries, public markets, supermarkets are open. Mm-hmm. And we allow the residents having a quarantine pass to go to these supermarkets. There are about 30 buses going around the city to provide transportation for all the residents of Iloilo City and also the medical frontliners.
Mm-hmm. Balita ko, Mayor, as part of the efforts to actually make sure that people have access to food, that the LGU, your LGU, has put up community kitchens. How do these work?
There are 240 community kitchens all over the city. Mm-hmm. We have 180 barangays, and the community kitchens provides lunch and dinner for about 200 residents of the barangay every day. And we've been doing that since the start of the ECQ in Iloilo City. Mm-hmm. Aside from that, we also have what we call the Kitchen Patrol, which provides almost 2,000 lunch and dinner also for the medical frontliners and the PNP and the Army who are watching the checkpoints. We have been doing that from the start of the ECQ. And we are very lucky because so many of our residents have been donating and contributing to the effort. We've been giving out food assistance to all the barangays, and we have given, I think, the seventh wave already. We continue to do that to ensure that food is available in the barangay, especially during this time when everyone has no work. Mm-hmm. And the amelioration fund has not yet been given to them. We were told by DSWD that the funds have been deposited to our account. But considering that we are still completing the list of the residents who will be made available the amelioration fund, we have not yet distributed the amelioration fund to them.
Nako, paano po yan, Mayor? We are already entering the third week, no, of the enhanced community quarantine. So, mahihirapan pa hubang i-release yung pera na yon within this week?
Well, within the week siguro ma-distribute na yan, no. But nagka problema because DSWD gave us a figure, and then all of a sudden they changed it. That's why we had to go back to the barangays and to inform them that the figure has been slashed. So most probably within the week, next week, we will be able to release the amelioration fund to the residents.
Mm-hmm. Let's clarify that point a bit, Mayor Jerry. When you say the figure was slashed by DSWD, how did they choose whom to remove from that list?
They gave us a list of those who are not qualified.
Yeah.
And going back, the barangay captains had to go back and to really make sure that all that will be listed, will be included in the list, will be qualified. Mm. It was unfortunate. I think there was some miscalculation on the part of the regional office of the SWD. But under the circumstances, we really have to go on with this. Mm-hmm. And make sure that the funds will be released at the earliest possible time.
So when you say a miscalculation was committed, they actually put some families within the bracket that would be considered the poorest of the poor when they actually yes. don't belong there?
Well, I think the part on the amelioration fund, the SWD gives us a certain figure.
Mm.
And it's like a quota, which we have to fill up with names. And I think there was a problem in the regional office in Region 6 that they miscalculated the figures. And when they asked, when we started already the listing, they told us that the figures have been miscalculated and we had to deduct some of them.
Ano po ba ang
for the whole?
Ano po ba ang quota na binibigay usually sa LGU? Quota ito in terms of yung the number of families that fall within the sabihin natin the low income bracket?
Yeah, I think it's the number of families that fall under the low income bracket, but at the same time the number that will be allowed for the city. And I think each of the municipality and the cities in Region 6 were given a particular quota. Mm-hmm. And what happened here is that there was a miscalculation on the part of the regional office of the SWD, and we had to go back to our barangays and inform them that they were getting a lower quota.
Nako. So doesn't that create a bit of parang sabihin na nating resentment on the part of some of the barangays?
We explained to them, insofar as Iloilo City is concerned, we have to explain to them that we have to move on and work on this fast. And the city will try to look for ways to make sure that those who were not included will be given some form of assistance during this time.
Mm, okay, so wala naman pong sabihin natin mapapabayaan, ano? Aside from the sa mabibigyan po ng social amelioration, the LGU can provide some other means of taking care of them during the enhanced community quarantine?
Yes, yes. As a matter of fact, the City Council already approved an appropriation of about 291 million mm-hmm. to make sure that we will have the funds during this time. And we will go on even with the release of the social amelioration fund. Mm-hmm. We will still go on with the food assistance in the community kitchen until everything has normalized.
How long do you think, Mayor Jerry, can you keep up the assistance? If you're not getting funds from the national government and you're relying purely on the revenue or the savings that you have within your own LGU, how long do you think you can keep on extending assistance to people under the lockdown?
We will be getting at least 1 month share in ERA from the national government, which we will be able to use as food assistance and also for the community kitchen and for the frontliners. So that will still give us some breathing spell.
Mm-hmm. So at least 1 month's worth po na internal revenue allotment nyo?
Yes, that's for Iloilo City, that's about 94 million. Mm-hmm. But as I have said, we already have prepared 291 for food assistance, for the community kitchens. And also, aside from this, we have 100 million also for cash for work. That is what we're looking at to use in case that the numbers that were deducted will no longer be accommodated by the SWD.
Yeah. You know, Mayor Jerry, I guess people are wondering, you know, why you declared an extended community quarantine within your own locality when the number of COVID positive cases in your area don't seem to be as high as those of other cities. Why did you take, you know, this kind of step?
We went into this enhanced community quarantine after consultation with all the governors in Panay and Guimaras to make sure that the number of COVID cases will not increase in Panay and Guimaras. And all actions that I have been doing in Iloilo City so far has been always in coordination with all the other governors in Panay and Guimaras. Mm. And we try to make sure that Panay and Guimaras will be free from COVID patients as much as possible. So we know that this disease is very difficult to cure. Mm-hmm. So we want to make sure that Iloilo City and Panay and Guimaras are safe.
So is the entire province still, you know, restricting movement in and out of Iloilo, or are there actually ships or flights that are arriving there in Iloilo?
Flights have been canceled.
Yeah.
Passenger ships have been canceled. But there is a free flow of goods coming from Manila, from Mindanao, mm-hmm. and out of Iloilo, going to Mindanao and Manila. You must understand, Tony, that Iloilo is one of the places where we grow a lot of rice. Mm. And people from Mindanao even buy rice from here in Iloilo.
Yeah. So trading, at least, has not been hampered by the ECQ?
No. Not insofar as trade is concerned. But we closed most of the establishments except essential establishments, yeah, like supermarkets, drugstores, markets, and food establishments, so that people can always go, but only for takeout.
Okay, so at least you're making sure that there are no mass gatherings in food establishments.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And in the situation, the situation in the supermarkets, Mayor, can you tell us whether the shelves are still fully stocked? Hindi po ba nagkakaubusan ang mga basic necessities?
Before I declared an ECQ here in Iloilo, I met with all the supermarkets and grocery store operators. And I made sure that all the food stuff in all the supermarkets will be available. And up to now, it has been available. We just want to make sure that food will always be available because, you know, if there's no food available in the barangays, it will be a problem.
Wala ho bang nahuhuling violators ng quarantine, Mayor?
May violators ng curfew. Mm-hmm. Nahuhuli bawat gabi, but what we do is we make them watch a video on COVID so that they will understand why they are going on curfew.
Naintindihan ho ba nila yung pinapanood nila?
Hopefully. Hopefully.
Hopefully. All right, Mayor Jerry Treñas of Iloilo City. Sir, we wish you, of course, and your constituents all the best, that you keep safe during this enhanced community quarantine. We'll see you on the other side once this outbreak is finally resolved. Thank you very much for speaking with us on ANZ Tonight, Mayor.
Thank you, Tony.
Thank you.
And good night.